I'm 75 now. I think I finally figured it out.
Next, trumpeter Herb Alpert, a life in harmony.
Herb Alpert's trumpet has been his horn of plenty for nearly half a century now. Among other things, it's won him 8 Grammys. With tonight's Grammy ceremony just hours away, Herb Alpert plays host to Russ Mitchell for the record.
It's a beautiful cloud formation.
It's right gorgeous. It's like a picture. I mean, it really is.
If you've ever wondered what it means to be living the good life, consider Herb Alpert.
It's pretty magical. I mean, I must admit, it's like we have this endless backyard, you know? Why, we can see Russia from here. Well, not quite.
We can
see Catalina.
Since the early 70s, the famed trumpeter's home has been 6 stunning acres on the beach in Malibu, California.
Well, this one's not in bronze. Most of the other ones are in bronze.
He designed the house and gardens himself, has his own recording studio, and all those beautiful sculptures, Herb Alpert originals.
I'm intrigued with what makes something engaging to look at. I'm looking for rhythm, I'm looking for motion.
But let's put all that aside for a moment, because any story about Herb Alpert has to begin with a horn. For a generation of listeners, the sound is unmistakable. The Latin-flavored smooth jazz of Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass.
Miles Davis said you hear 3 notes and you know it's Herb Alpert.
Yeah.
Where does that style come from?
It's just the real me. I'm not affecting anything. It's just the way the sound comes out. You know, one of my teachers used to tell me, hey, man, you're just playing a piece of plumbing. That's how he described the horn and the trumpet.
That piece of plumbing has served him well. 6 top 10 hits, 8 Grammys, his unique South of the Border sound selling more than 70 million albums. Quite an accomplishment for a shy Jewish kid from East L.A.
My father was born in Russia, from a little town outside of Kiev. My mother was from Lower East Side of New York.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not Hispanic, and I know a lot of people think that
You're not Hispanic? Herb Alpert's not Hispanic?
No.
The Tijuana Brass?
No.
He picked up the trumpet at age 8 and never put it down. But he didn't discover the sound that would make him famous until his mid-20s, while attending a bullfight in Mexico.
Tijuana had some world-class matadors. Then this trumpet section in the stands, you know, they would announce the different programs, the different events in the bullfight. You're like, ba-da, ba-da, da, 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 da. I got kind of chill bumped from all that stuff, and I tried to translate the feeling of those afternoons to a song.
The Lonely Bull was a top 10 hit in 1962, and with the money it brought in, Alpert and a friend, Jerry Moss, decided to produce the next album themselves. Alpert and Moss formed the now legendary A&M Records. During the next 3 decades, A&M would release more than 30 Herb Alpert albums. One, Whipped Cream and Other Delights, was as popular for the cover art as for the music.
She was covered in shaving cream.
It's ruining the fantasy.
I know.
You see this guy? This guy's in love with you.
In 1968, he had a number 1 hit as a singer.
I'm in love.
A popular TV show, The Dating Game, used his tunes as its theme music.
What do your good friends call you?
What my good friends call me?
Yeah.
Living.
He even had his own primetime specials. Meanwhile, A&M Records was growing into a powerhouse, handling some of the biggest names of the era. Cat Stevens, Peter Frampton, and Janet Jackson, among others. But there was one band Herb Alpert discovered that was closest to his heart.
Well, I signed the Carpenters in 1969 or 1970.
It was Alpert who convinced Karen and Richard Carpenter to record the song that would make them superstars.
When that song happened, all of a sudden, I turned into a genius to the people that didn't like them.
Close to You was, of course, a smash. But the Carpenters' career would end in tragedy with Karen's death from anorexia at age 32. Nearly 30 years later, her memory still haunts him.
I loved Karen. She was a wonderful lady. She was... Every time I think about her, it seems so unfair. She was great.
Do you remember the last time you saw her?
Yeah, I do remember the last time I saw her. But, I mean, the irony is she never realized how great she was. She never really accepted the fact that she really had it.
By 1989, Alpert had had it with the music industry. And when giant PolyGram Records made an offer he couldn't refuse, he didn't. Alpert and Moss sold A&M for a reported $460 million.
Came out okay in this deal.
Came out okay, yeah.
Yeah.
What's the secret?
The secret?
Yeah, secret to a happy, long marriage.
Communication.
Since then, Alpert and his wife of 37 years, singer Lani Hall, have been doing, well, whatever they want.
Exactly. Laughter.
Yeah.
Romance.
This is where the magic happens.
This
huh?
is where, well, sometimes magic happens, sometimes not. Wow.
Alpert paints and sculpts seriously. He's at gallery shows. And if you'd like to buy what you see.
From like 200 to maybe 300,000.
Ah, okay.
And all the leaves on the trees are falling to the sound of the breezes below.
Herb and Lani had it made, and they knew it. So they decided to start giving back. In 1988, they established the Herb Alpert Foundation. So far, they've given away more than $100 million, promoting education in the arts.
Welcome to our home, our musical home in Harlem.
One of his most recent causes is New York's Harlem School of the Arts. A neighborhood fixture since 1964, last spring, hard times forced the school to shut its doors. 3,000 miles away, Alpert read about it in the newspaper.
Herb woke up one morning and saw the headline that the school was going to close. And he said, that can't happen. And they wrote a check for $500,000.
Just out of the blue?
Out of the blue.
Charles Hamilton is the school's chairman.
Without Herb Alpert, this school would be closed today. We owe that. We owe a great debt of thanks to him for that.
Okay, you like jazz?
Oh, good.
That's my dad. Dunk, dunk, dunk with your foot. That's hard to do.
We love you.
Thanks so much.
We love you.
I am so blessed. And I just feel compelled to pass it on.
This is what it's all about.
Wow. It's just been very fulfilling. And then to walk through this facility and talk to the people involved, I mean, it's chilling for me. I know this sounds a little corny, but I get it. I dig it.
No matter where his interests take him, all roads lead back to the trumpet. Herb and Lani have just released a new CD and are heading out on a cross-country tour. So if you want to know what Herb Alpert's been up to since his heyday so many years ago, he's been playing music, painting, sculpting, and helping others fulfill their dreams. In other words, living the good life.
Maybe we'll see a couple of whales, a couple of porpoises.
I think a heron.